Lincoln 103, 5 Lincoln 102, Lincoln 103 and 102.
Responding to 401 parking structure, section 1 boy.
Henry 8, Henry 9, respond to gate 437 Bravo for your dignitary detail. 3K911, unattended 400 lower level near carousel 4, black bag. GTA in progress, 401 parking structure, section 4 boy.
Responding to 401 parking structure, section 1 boy.
415 passenger onboard aircraft.
Control 2 Franklin and Brown.
484 suspect, the female, Hispanic, 28 years of age. Blue G, no further.
Control, high Frank, 401 is a route.
Good morning. Good morning and welcome to this edition of the Private Officer Beat Radio, sponsored by Private Officer International, and I'm your host, founder and CEO, Rick McCann. Hey, today we've got a lot to talk about. It's a busy, busy day here, Thursday morning, bright and early. A lot on our plate. We're going to go over some of the benefits of being a POI member. Some of those have changed, been updated. Some have been deleted while others have been added. So we do want to go over that. We're going to be talking about the upcoming Private Officer Award, annual award program that we have, as well as the current contest happening now. Maybe you've heard of this or not. Our annual officer well-dressed and patrol vehicle contest. Anyone can enter, both members and non-members. We'll be talking about that as well. So we do have a lot of stuff to talk about today. And, of course, we always have a bunch of news. And you don't want to miss out on any of this. So welcome. Thanks for being here with us. We just had an email come through about a day and a half ago. Somebody from an African state. Location who has been listening faithfully, he said, for more than 3 years, and he has told others, we have members in Africa and many other countries, and we have a lot of communications with Johannesburg and other areas in South Africa, and we've had some members from Trinidad and other areas. So, hey, we are truly an international company, a membership that is available to private security, law enforcement, public safety, the alarm industry, PIs, and anyone working in the frontline services. All you have to do is go to our website, privateofficer.org, and sign up. And while we're talking about the website, we definitely want to recognize and thank the people over there, our friends at Body Armor USA. We've got what it takes to protect you, and you should not forget that. Don't go anyplace else before you check out what we can offer you. Body Armor USA, we've got you covered. Our friends over there will take care of you and give you a discount just for letting them know that you are a listener of the POI radio. Whew, see, already a lot. Already a lot to talk about, a lot happening. We've got police radios going off in the background. We've got phones already ringing this morning so early. We've got texts and emails happening. And as we've told you before, we have more than 2,000 news feeds coming into our office 24/7. And that's how we're able to be on top of the news 24/7 and get that out to you. The news you need, the news that you want to hear, and the news that many of you use for the training. So always something happening, even at 3 o'clock in the morning. I was in the office, been about 2 weeks ago now, with our overnight staff. And, yeah, there was no time to sleep, no time to take a nap, no time to close their eyes. They were busy and really jumping around. And that's going to really intensify as we have more and more different type of businesses now coming all under one roof as we're moving into a brand new corporate location. And we're very excited about that. We should be in there by midsummer, maybe early fall at the very latest, but hopefully before. And all of our businesses will then be all under one roof and in one dispatch communication control center. And that's going to work out lovely. It's going to work out very beneficial. So we'll be telling you more about that coming up, I'm sure, over the next few months. And like I said, as we grow, we have a lot of different job opportunities from entry level all the way to management. And we often put those out in our newsletters and across our email. So if you need a job and you're in the right place at the right time, we'd love to hear from you. And of course, you can always send your resume right now to helpdesk@privateofficer.com. They will forward it to our HR manager and they'll review it. If it's something that, you know, we need, we'll definitely be contacting you. Either way, we'll let you know that we did receive it and we are reviewing it. We have a lot of entry level and managerial type positions in a number of our companies as we continue to grow. In fact, we're now investing in several companies and intend to invest in several more. So there's going to be a lot of opportunity for you personally to move up if you want to change jobs, if you want to go into a different area. Like I said, just send your resume to helpdesk@privateofficer.com. Also, if you have a company, security agency, a security or medical training school, we'd love to hear from you. We'll talk about what you have and what we might be able to bring to the table. You can contact helpdesk@privateofficer.com as your point of contact, and they'll pass it along to the appropriate people, and they will reach out to you. We always have had a lot going on, but just in the last few years, we've really picked up the pace. We've really began to expand, and it's exciting times around here. If you need more information about that, the help desk will always be your contact for everything. And if you're a member and you need some assistance with anything, the help desk is always going to be your point of contact 24/7, helpdesk@privateofficer.com. So much to talk about. Like I said, this morning we're going to be going over the benefits that you have as a member or as a potential member. We're also going to be discussing a lot of breaking news. And right in just a second, just hold on, we're going to be talking about the contest we have and, of course, the annual officer awards. I do want to mention something that really is disturbing, and if, in fact, we've talked about this a number of times, but in the last 2 or 3 years, suicides of security officers have either risen pretty dramatically or the public is becoming more aware of it. The media is becoming more aware of it. And yesterday we sent out a letter about a female security officer who committed suicide. That happened early Wednesday morning. It really touched my heart, and it's something that is very dear and close to me. Officers of law enforcement, officers of the security industry, really having to face all of these issues. Poor wages, poor support, working alone, working crazy hours, never knowing where they're going to be or what hours they're going to work, what they're going to face. In my email yesterday that I sent out, I talked about, you know, just this past weekend, more than a dozen security officers were shot. Three of them were in an actual gunfight, fighting for their life, bullets exchanged. One was in a Waffle House in New Orleans where he's in serious but stable condition and hopefully will pull through. Two men came in to rob the place at gunpoint. And the security officer, he really put up a fight, and there was a number of rounds shot off. And the same thing happened at an apartment complex over the weekend. A security officer involved in a shooting, really in a gun battle. And luckily, he had a vest, and it saved his life. But we see this on a daily basis, assaults, stabbings, shootings of security officers. It's not monthly. It's not weekly. It's not occasional. It's daily, and we have the proof. A lot of people just don't believe that security officers face the same threats as law enforcement, and that simply is not true. They face more threats, as they are more likely to be attacked than law enforcement because there's really very little that security officers can do. Most are not armed. They don't have backup. They don't have assistance. Most do not have two-way radios. And it's tragic what's going on out there. Things have been changing for many years, and unfortunately, not too many people have taken notice. But suicides are on the rise. In my email yesterday, I put the information where you can contact a number of organizations that can help you. If you have any thoughts of doing any harm to yourself, be sure to reach out to them or to us always, 24/7, helpdesk at privateofficer.com. We're there to help you out. We are going to take a quick break when we come back. A whole lot more to talk about. And we'll be talking about the contest and the upcoming annual awards as well. We'll be right back. You're listening to the Private Officer Beat Radio.
Every 40 seconds, someone around the world takes their own life. Every 13 minutes, someone in the U.S. commits suicide. While you were getting ready for work this morning, in the first hour of your day, as many as 5 people in the U.S. have killed themselves. By lunchtime, about 20 people in the U.S. have taken their own life. At the end of an 8-hour workday, about 40 people in the U.S. killed themselves. In a 24-hour period, as many as 111 people in the U.S. committed suicide.
My name's Melissa Kinsey, and I'm with the YMCA of Lincoln. Drowning can happen in an instant. Your kids need to be safe not only in the swimming pool, but at the lake, and even in the bathtub. So what you can do to keep your kids safe is to supervise them. Put down the phone. Put down the book and sit and watch. Sit and play. Put your swimming suit on and make sure that your kids are always in view and they will have a great summer.
Today we want to spend a little bit of time doing a review of our private officer benefits, member benefits. These are specific to our association members and not something offered to folks who follow us on social media or our news blogs or others who are supporters. These are specific to all of our members, and these are posted on our website at privateofficer.org. But today I want to kind of go over them and do a quick review because there has been some recent updates and additions. So, you know, as with any organization, of course, we do offer a really very nice certificate and member card. But some of the more specific programs and benefits that we offer, we have a free state-specific will that's been drawn up by an attorney. Now, many people cannot afford to go to an attorney and get a will done. So this is a legit will, and it's very important to have a will, even if you have no real assets. If you have anything at all, you want to put it down on paper because when we're gone, we never know what our family and others will do or try to do, and if you want someone to have something specific, you want to put it down in writing, have it notarized. So we have these, and this is part of your member packet. We have a $3,000 on-duty death benefit, which is raised to $5,000 in certain circumstances. This is coming out of our pocket. It's not through an insurance company. We're not going to submit this for some type of payoff to some company. This is coming out of our pocket. It's a benefit specific to our members, something that will help in the time of death when families may or may not have the money for burial, for other funeral arrangements and expenses. We offer several wellness programs, including assisting officers who have medical conditions and may be out of work, or they've had a disaster like has recently happened in the last couple of years, hurricanes where our members' homes were destroyed. Several of our instructors had damage to their homes and vehicles. We're here, and we will help you within our means. We also offer credit unions. We have two specific credit unions. We also have chaplains, which will assist you 24 hours a day if you have any type of emergency, and we also have counselors. You do have to contact us and give us some particulars on what's happening so that we can make those arrangements for you. Of course, one of the benefits as a member, you always have free access to our staff, our legal department, which consists of paralegals and attorneys. We have on-call assistance, and we're able to assist you with questions that you might have. They may give you some legal advice. We can assist you with a whole array of things that happen in real life. Contact us. Career mapping and mentoring programs where we help individuals determine what the best career path might be for them, depending on their skill sets or their ambitions. And again, it's something that we do on a one-on-one basis. We offer hotel and auto discounts. We have equipment discounts. We're constantly advertising different specials. We have security newsletters. Many of you are signed up to receive those. And if not, you can go to our website at privateofficer.org today and sign up. Very beneficial. You can use it for training. You can use that information for learning. You can use it for advancing your own company. It's a free item that we give to everyone, not just to members. Some of the other areas that are specific to members is we have a fantastic award program. Not only do we issue certificates, we have plaques. We have a lot of different type of awards that you can submit someone to receive. You can also submit yourself, and it's all right there on our website at privateofficer.org. We offer a lot of training, both through Private Officer and Armor College, a public safety trade accredited school. We also offer a lot of seminars and conferences. We have seminars online. All that you have to do is sign up for them when they're offered. No charge or very little charge to our members. This is something that we've been doing since we were organized in 2004, and it really is a great benefit to our members. We have a lot of discounted merchandise, both in our store on the website as well as offered regularly through our email post, and both POI merchandise and other gear as well. We offer something that I think is very special in the industry. We have our own private security officer memorial every year. It's the third week of September. This is something that's not really membership specific, but rather industry-wide specific. It recognizes private officers killed in the line of duty while protecting life and property, and it's for private security as well as private law enforcement. We have a number of other member benefits that are specific to the individual. Some are advertised, some are not. But here's the bottom line. Anytime that you have a question, anytime that you need assistance, anytime that you want to do something and you're not sure who to reach out to, all that you have to do is contact us 24/7, helpdesk@privateofficer.com, helpdesk frontline@privateofficer.com. We offer about 40 different member benefits. These are specific, and oftentimes, unfortunately, our members do not take advantage of them, but they are here for you. Like I said, they may be listed on our member page on the website, or they may not be. We're always updating, upgrading, sometimes deleting some that are not used or wanted, and putting something else new. If you want any information on the benefits, contact helpdesk@privateofficer.com today, because as a member, we want you to use those benefits. They are there for you. All right, well, that's just a quick overview. Like I said, if you have questions, please contact us so that we can get those questions answered for you. If you have other benefits that you think we should add, send those to helpdesk@privateofficer.com so we can review and consider those. All right, that's going to close out this segment. We'll come back in a moment, and we'll be talking a little bit about the news.
Slow down.
Slow down and move over.
And move over.
When you see lights,
vest,
I'll be flaggers.
Please, give us some room. Slow down and move over.
When you need us,
we've got your back.
You have ours.
You got our back?
You got ours? You got our back? Please, slow down.
And move over.
Fantastic day.
What a fantastic day.
The water's like glass.
The water is like glass.
Don't forget the soda.
Don't forget the life jackets.
Who wants the 8 and who wants the 15?
Who wants the inflatables?
What a great day.
To be on the water.
So glad you saw me go over.
That was so funny when you went over and your life jacket inflated.
Never go out without a life jacket on again.
What a great day we had.
When it comes to wearing life jackets, make the right choice. You're in command. Vote responsibly. This message brought to you by the National Safe Boating Council and the U.S. Coast Guard.
All right, we have a lot of news coming out this week, just like always. A lot of breaking news 24/7, and we're here so that you'll be informed. Some disturbing news coming out of Virginia. Virginia State Police have arrested one of their own. State Trooper Justin Hips was arrested for possession of child pornography, and he's currently locked up in the Allegheny County Jail. Unfortunately, you know, officers are humans, they make mistakes, but this is not acceptable. And this situation happens more than you know, unfortunately, and the troopers have taken care of it. In Key West, police there say a man who recently bought an $8 million island off Key West is accused of stealing $300 worth of merchandise from Kmart. And he did it in a very unique way. What he did was he returned some coffee makers, but they were just boxes filled with junk. And he got a refund for those. And that happens much more than you think as well across the country. In fact, in my years of loss prevention, one of the biggest things that people used to do was come in and take a big wheel, one of those little plastic toy wheelie things, and take it out of the box and fill it up with electronics and CDs and expensive stuff, and go to the register and pay $29 and walk out with $400 or $500 worth of merchandise. Chicago, Illinois, police there are disgusted. A McDonald's security officer was attacked violently by two men, not the first time, at the Gold Coast McDonald's. He eventually pulled his firearm. No shots were fired. Police are looking for those thugs, those people who attacked the security officer. And security said this is not the first time it's happened there. In fact, several security officers have been attacked there in recent months. In Fulton County, Georgia, that's the Atlanta metro area, police there say a man dressed fully in U.S. Marshals gear walked into a bar saying that he was there to arrest a female. Security officer did not believe him, asked for identification and a warrant, and he took off. Police later arrested the man, charged him with impersonating a federal law enforcement officer. David Anthony Flood Jr. is currently in the Fulton County Jail. A traffic stop out of Tucson, Arizona recently this week netted police $1 million, 60 pounds worth of meth. Police said a canine officer assigned to the Border Interdiction Unit with the Pima County Sheriff's Department conducted the routine traffic stop on Interstate 10, and soon the drug dog alerted and 60 pounds of meth taken off the street. A Florida man and woman picked the wrong Walmart in the wrong state to operate a gift card theft operation. The man and the woman wanted in multiple areas for the same gig was caught trying to steal more than 12,000 gift cards in Newberry Township, Pennsylvania. Loss prevention there was able to detect that situation. James Lewis West, 25, and Tisha Renee Wimbush, both of Tampa, are charged with several felonies and currently in the jail. Morris Security Company out of Passaic County is minus one worker. A security worker sexted a 12-year-old girl, and police got wind of it and arrested Michael J. Chickalillo, Jr. of Riverdale, New Jersey. He's been charged, and he also is currently in jail with no bond. Two people, a male and a female, was recently arrested in Wilmington, North Carolina, accused of robbing a Walmart there with a gun. When loss prevention tried to detain the two for shoplifting, they pulled a gun on the loss prevention agent. Police was able to quickly scoop them up. Edward Hoffman and Audrey Cross both have been charged with armed robbery. In Joliet, Illinois, a Job Corps security guard has been arrested after bringing a teenager into the security office and exposing himself and propositioning the teenager. She quickly reported it to staff, and police were called and arrested him. Police now have charged Antonio Hopkins, 28, of Dalton, Illinois, with public indecency, battery, and disorderly conduct. He's been released on his own recognizance and will appear in court at a later date. In Central Florida, Orlando, at the University of Central Florida, police there have, they've got a little bit of a hiring dilemma. They have 12 new positions because they've expanded. They have a brand new downtown Orlando campus where they're going to have 12 police officers. They've also assigned a canine. Authorities there say that they will have additional law enforcement authority in the downtown Orlando area, and they'll be called to assist on many different situations. New York State? Well, I guess in New York State, you can be a felon. You can steal $100,000 from a former security company, and they're going to hire you. A owner of a security company who is currently facing felony grand larceny charges for overbilling the city for more than $100,000 has now been hired by the state despite his ongoing criminal case. Abdulouf Saini, 49, the president of First Alert Security Services in Brooklyn, was arrested back in September after a Department of Investigation probe revealed that he overcharged the School Construction Authority for security guard services for more than 2 years. But even though he's been charged with that felony and he's undergoing that process, it has not been adjudicated. The state has hired him anyways, and they're going to be paying him $103,000 for his services. In California, a security guard has been arrested for a armed road rage where he fired shots. This is actually the third time in just 2 months where private security officers have been involved in road rage incidents, and they have fired off their weapons. Police say that They were notified of the incident. The security officer fled the area, but soon was arrested in a nearby industrial park. Last month, a shooting on Interstate 95 by a security officer in Florida ended with him in custody, no injuries there. And then back in February, another road rage incident involving an armed security officer in Minneapolis, Minnesota, where he shot a 78-year-old school bus driver. Kenneth Lilly was arrested and booked, and he is still incarcerated. In Carson City, Nevada, police there responded to one of the local casinos after security was assaulted during a disturbance, and they have taken one man into custody. Thomas Raymond Brown has been charged with assault, disorderly conduct after a fight with security. He has a court case pending as well. You may or may not have heard this, but just in the last few days in Maryland, police, federal, and local thwarted a plot by a man who had an ISIS-inspired plan to attack pedestrians in the National Harbor there in Baltimore. He, Rodney Henry, 28, of Germantown, Maryland, stole a U-Haul and had plans of running over as many people as he could down in that National Harbor area where there's always a lot of pedestrians and a lot of visitors. Police in Las Vegas said a school district police officer stole from 22 schools. The sergeant, who was on duty and off duty during the time, has been arrested. Sergeant Robert Griffin faces numerous felony counts, including 70 charges now. New charges have been added this week. He evidently stole everything that he could get his hands on and loaded it up into his marked patrol car. Five teenagers in Arvada, Colorado, that's in the Denver metro area, are now locked up after they injured a police officer and a civilian when they planted a chemical bomb out into the middle of the road in a neighborhood. Went off as officers and a civilian tried to remove it. Maxwell McCann, 18, Braden Almer, 19, Isaac Koch, 19, Gavin Dawson, 19, and an unnamed juvenile, all are charged with first-degree assault and possession and use of explosives and or incendiary devices, and now the feds, ATF, want to charge them federally. Yeah, it's no game. It's, a lot of kids, they take things off YouTube and they put things together thinking, oh, it's fun and games, but it's not. Reno, Nevada, a homeless shelter there who recently had a man found dead on their roof after 3 days. He was there for 3 days now. No one found him. They've decided to hire armed security, not only because of that suspicious death, but also because of other incidents happening at the Volunteers of America homeless shelter there in Reno. We've noticed in the last few years that many homeless shelters are beginning to not only hire security, but hire armed security. Culver City, California, security officer interrupted a domestic violence situation in the middle of the street where he was working. The man was armed. The security officer fired several shots. Police arrived and took the suspect into custody. No injuries are reported. We have a lot of news. Go to our website at privateofficer.org today. Sign up. It's free. You can get those news items in your mailbox every single day. Newsletters twice a week and breaking news as it happens. privateofficer.org. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we've got a whole lot more coming up on this program. Stand by.
What a fantastic day.
What a fantastic day.
The water is like glass.
The water is like glass.
Don't forget the soda.
Don't forget the life jacket.
Who wants the 8 and who wants the 15?
Who wants the inflatables?
What a great day.
To be on the water.
So glad you saw me go over.
That was so funny. When you went over and your life jacket inflated.
Never go out without a life jacket on again.
What a great day we had.
When it comes to wearing life jackets, make the right choice. You're in command. Vote responsibly. This message brought to you by the National Safe Boating Council and the U.S. Coast Guard.
Federal Aviation Administration wants you to fly your drone responsibly. Avoid flying your drone near other aircraft, especially near airports. Fly your drone below 400 feet. Always keep your drone in sight. If you see a safety issue involving drones, contact local law enforcement immediately. Fly smart. Fly safe. Have fun.
David, you okay to drive?
Yeah, I only had a couple drinks. I'm fine.
Come on.
Keys can be a weapon. A few drinks can make you a killer.
So we're back on the air. That was really a good break. It was a good break for us, wasn't it? Sitting here in the studio live at the Charlotte, North Carolina studios. You know, some breaks they're not so good. Other breaks are good because there's lots of things that, we have to do when we're, you know, on break, like, you know, go to the potty, grab us another cup of coffee. And this morning, we got some fresh bagels from one of our great bagel stores down the road, not too far. So that was a good break, and we're enjoying ourselves here this morning in the studio. So we talked about, before we went to break, we talked about some of the things also coming up. And one of those we're actually in the midst of, and that is the annual Officer and Patrol Vehicle Contest. We're looking for the best dressed and the best marked patrol car. The best dressed officer, of course. I guess you could dress a car. If you put markings on it, isn't that kind of a dressing? No, not a salad dressing. A dressing like, you know, you get clothes on. Anyways, we're looking for the best dressed officer and the best looking patrol car. Send at least two full shot pictures. Gotta include everything. Not just a headshot. Gotta include you in uniform. Or a couple of good shots of your marked patrol vehicle to helpdesk@privateofficer.com. helpdesk@privateofficer.com. This contest will end next week, so be sure to do that today. And then coming up just in about 10 days, we've got the annual Officer Award Program, where members and non-members can submit themselves or others, co-workers, for awards. And this is something we've been doing almost since day one of our existence here at Private Officer International. So we'll be sending out emails and announcing that coming up in a few days. Be sure to participate. Every year we give out about 165 to 190 awards throughout the year, but the bulk of them are during the annual award program. This is one of those benefits that we have for everybody, not just members, but non-members too, as we recognize all the good that security officers do and private police officers do across the country and around the world. So don't miss that. It's an important part of what we do, and we want you to be included. And make sure you get those pictures of yourself in full uniform and your fully marked patrol car into us at helpdesk@privateofficer.com. helpdesk@privateofficer.com. Now, we do have a lot of things happening, and people ask us all the time, did I miss this? Did I miss that? When was this? How come I didn't hear about it? We broadcast everything on our radio shows. We send out constant emails every time there's an event coming up, whether that's a free training or a contest or an annual award program or the memorial. We send it all out because we want people to be informed. We also use 5 different social media platforms, and those are our, go-to platforms. And 2 of them, both Twitter and Facebook, are our main platforms for social media. So if you follow us on those, or you follow our news blogs, and there's 2 of them, or you follow our radio program, or you follow our website, or you just, are in constant contact with us, then guess what? You're not going to miss a thing, because you're going to have notifications, multiple notifications of those things happening, and you're going to be involved. So be sure, if you haven't already signed up, be sure that you are signed up for our news alerts, our newsletters. Go to our website, privateofficer.org, and sign up today. Also, right now, if you have, this is a special, if you're not a member and you want to be a member, if you go to our website at privateofficer.org, we have a special $99 lifetime membership, and you're going to get a POI patch, a POI lapel, and an 8-week online training program absolutely free. You can't beat it. If you need any more information about that special, I mean, we're giving away the store for sure. We really are. I mean, when you think about lifetime membership, which normally, most associations charge $400 or $500 for, a free online course, patches and lapel pins, all of that is a pretty nice package, all for just $99. Also, we have a special right now. If you want to advertise on our website, on our social media, on our radio programs, via our newsletters, we have a deal for you. $99 a month, 3-month minimum. If you want to advertise for the year, we'll do it right now. $900. Contact helpdesk at privateofficer.com. We have people ask this question all the time of our help desk. We have more followers, because we've been in this so long, 15 years plus, we have more followers on our social media, our news websites, our primary website, all of those combined. We have millions of hits every month, and we have really racked up the followers. We've racked up the databases. We've racked up the contacts. So now really is the most beneficial time for you to advertise with us. Contact helpdesk at privateofficer.com. And like I said, do not, if you're not a member currently, do not pass up that 99 lifetime special free 8-week course, lapel pin, and POI patch. What a package. What a deal. Contact helpdesk at privateofficer.com for any information that you need. We do want to thank Body Armor USA, one of our longtime sponsors. We've got what it takes to protect you. Be sure to look them up online at bodyarmorusa.com. They've got all types of protective gear, clothing, body armor. They've got it all. If you need protection, whether you're a correction officer, loss prevention, law enforcement, security, they can help you out. Our buddies there are standing by, and they're going to give you 10% off just for saying that you heard it on the POI radio. BodyArmorUSA.com. We've got what it takes to protect you. Now, we've got a lot going on, but we do need to take another quick break. When we come back, we've got a lot to share with you. So don't go away. You're listening to the Private Officer Beat Radio. All right, my friends, that's going to do it for this episode of the Private Officer Beat Radio. Collectively, all of our office staff, our management people, even our members across the country and around the world, we're just excited. We're excited when people find us, when people hear about us and they join, when people who have been following us for a long time make that decision to become part of the association. It's not just about being a member. It's about being part of the family. And we want you as a member to get involved. Join a chapter. Start a chapter. Get involved in training. Become a certified instructor. Help out with the officer down response team. You know, there's so many different avenues. You can even join the advisory board. You can be an advisory board member. You can be a committee member. Get involved today. Contact helpdesk@privateofficer.com. Well, that's going to do it for us on this episode of the Private Officer Beat. And, you know, I'd be amiss and I'd be out of whack if I just didn't tell you that we do care about you, whether you are a member or not. And if you have any question or need, just contact us, helpdesk@privateofficer.com. Thanks for being here on the Private Officer Beat Radio. Until the next time, be safe, be blessed, and we'll see you back here on the radio.